Hello there, my dear friends. Sorry it has been a little long while, but I have been doing pretty well, as you saw from my other videos. I think I'm making very good progress in my sentence and hard labor. And on the downside, I think I'm rebuilding my reputation, even though I don't care about it. So, you guys can ask me how you think I'm doing for my posts, if you wish. I couldn't post the last video in relation to Indiana Jones by Don G. Corleone, but luckily enough, I was able to give my opinion, and I don't think it was too horrible. So I think maybe it's very good progress. Yeah. You know, I thought this sentence would be painful. Well, I guess it was at first, but now it's starting to help out. I think I'm maturing quite a bit. But anyway, now that I think about maturity, sorry, I spot there. I'm afraid before I get to announce the next fanfic that I'm going to be putting in the description, I'm shouting out to Tanisha, also known as Girlofthewater. At least that's what I think she called herself. Stand by. Don't worry, don't lose your heads. Girlofthewater. And let me read this out. Thank God for guest reviews, because this one is really going to buzz my head. And let's just say I'm shouting out big time. This guest said that's the plan, and it's already too late on me stressing out, because my anxiety is through the roof. There are people out there who are wanting me to update not only my Kalos fiction, but my Power Ranger fiction as well. I'm only one person, and I can only focus on one fiction at a time. There's one reader in particular who keeps saying amazing chapters over and over again, but doesn't understand that I need more than him saying that in the reviews. I reached out to him in a PM. That's personal messages when you want to speak to somebody without anyone else knowing. And in the shout out. But he ignored it. So right now, I don't know if I can keep posting all four Pokemon fictions on here or take them down and keep posting them on another website. Yeah, and I got a reaction from this fan. Yeah, I booked the guest too. Great, thanks a lot, idiots. Now look what you did. Yeah, I have to agree. Nice going, you morons. You blew it for everyone. And Water Girl, yeah, I think she needs a vacation from these motherfuckers. Those are fools, but still. And I hope there are more people out there that are like me that are more patient. Well, you're not wrong. Consider myself one of them, buddy. And yes, she's human and she has her limits and are willing to help you in any way possible. Well, that's why I'm shouting out. I know these guys are out there. So if anyone can hunt down those mother truckers on the fanfiction, by all means, go after them. Trust me, not every guest is awful, but I'm sure this one's going out. Oh yeah, you can also go after this truckhead as well. Dang it. Yeah, you see where it says the amazing chapter? Look at the top name. I'm sure you guys can track this person down and give him a good hanging job. I know, Tanisha, I know it's going crazy, but this... I'm being patient with your work, but this forcing your hand, I might as well be hanging myself over the building of the high cliffs that this crap keeps up, because it's no better than what I was doing. Then again, it was different. So that's my big shout out. And Tanisha, do whatever it takes. If you need my help, you know where to find me. Every one of these mutters. Anyway, to my main fiction, which, my apologies, even though this is a, I did say this is a shout out and a cry for help. Dang it. It doesn't have the full details, but do you remember the OC character, Lara's love interest, her boyfriend, Owen Taylor, in the Tomb Raider fanfiction that was by Game Psycho 11? Well, this one's the sequel to it, The Rise of the Tomb Raider. It doesn't have the information, but I can tell you this. As you know, after Lara came back, she's been extremely... experience her own traumas, but let's just say after realizing so much, she also kind of tried to look at her father's research, the one that let him obsessed and has result ejected his own daughter. And ironically, their last conversation was an argument, and then boom, add a bullet to his head. To be fair, I remember reading it and I remember watching it. It was difficult to take in. But anyway, this obsession, let's just say most of it's similar, but most of it's different. But to be fair, it's perfectly balanced. And I can tell you this, Lara's obsession with finding something that her father was trying to get find himself, it was also destroying not just herself, but it was also destroying her relationship with Owen, which if you read the fan fiction, they're engaged, but the obsession caused a huge argument. And what did he do? Walked out on Lara after she refused to give a bloody answer. Harsh, really, really harsh. But you guys can read the story, and I'm sure you guys would enjoy it. Which I also have another announcement too. My wells are drying up. Fanfics, guess what? I need to figure out a plan B to keep this channel going, or otherwise I might as well throw myself into retirement and go out of here, especially after everything. So even though I don't deserve your help, guys, can you help me out? Let's see, what's the next fanfic I can speak about? Ah, actually, it's in regards to our whole world changed one day when all these random cards started springing down everywhere. I remember that one. And I think maybe you know where this is coming from. I'll show you that fanfic when I can, and we'll work out the details later. But I'm not going to lie to you, I'm running out of ideas and plans faster than I can replace them. So, yeah. Alrighty then. Time for me to go. I'll be giving my guest what's out as well as a small consolation prize and a gift. So then, bye bye now.